I'm here again. Today we're going to talk about another Revit bottom call extended to 3D view. In previous videos, we review a simplified and straightforward version of this bottom, which was called to 3D view with section box, that you can also find already in our channel. But today's video is going to enable you to select elements and create 3D views with section boxes, as well as to establish side-by-side windows with a 3D view while you're working in another view. Quite helpful to understand elements and geometries when working on ceiling floor plans or any other floor plan. So this button is part of the set of bottoms, the best of the best, and it is available in NonicaTab free, completely for free at Autodesk App Store. So feel free to check it out. Let's jump into Revit. Let's say we're working on this floor plan. So what we can do is we can actually create a 3D view with a section box containing the elements we don't understand or we want to check. So for example, if we want to check this object, what we can do is we can go to NonicaTab free, and then we click on extended to 3D view. So then we are given a few options. The first one is which view we want to create the located view. So for example, we're going to select 3D view interior, the extra size. So if we set this value to 0, the section box is going to be, let's say, containing the elements to the limit. So if we want the section box to be a little bit bigger, we can set the section box a little bit bigger as well. So let's set this to 2. And then the last option, which is add 3D view to side of current view. Basically, what this is going to enable us to do is to create a side window next to this floor plan that shows this element in 3D. So we can keep the current view open while we explore the object in 3D view. This is quite handy, but actually if we have like several views open, only going to remain open the current view and the 3D view selected. In this case, for example, we have another 3D view here. So we're going to see how this works. Okay, so we just click on create section box. And then we see that, well, on the right part, we still have the floor plan that we were working on. And on the left part of the screen, we have the, let's say, the 3D view with the element we selected. As previously mentioned, it has like a section box a little bit bigger than the element, as you see. So we can actually understand what is going on around the object as well. This bottom is also quite helpful, for example, if you have like scope boxes that are rotated or off axis. So you can create 3D views using those scope boxes as section box for the 3D views. So let's click again on extended to 3D view, and then it asks us to select the elements. So we're going to select the scope box, in this case, this one. As you see, the scope box is a little bit rotated. Okay, great. So we click on finish, and then again, we can select the 3D view. We're going to select the same 3D view, and then the extra size. Well, in this case, we're going to set it to 0. Because we don't want a side-to-side window, we can just leave this unmarked, and then we click on create. As you see, we have the new 3D view with the section box containing the scope box that we selected. That's it. I hope you find it helpful. See you soon. Bye-bye.